with the scan conversion techniques. So scan conversion techniques, scan conversion means the, as we know, we are here using the raster images, correct? So when we use the raster images, what normally perform, it starts from the top and top to bottom, it scan the lines from top to bottom and left to right, correct? If this is an image like this, suppose this is your screen, then in raster image it is scanned the line, every line. So start from where I can scanning this line means from top to bottom and from left to right. So in this way each line is scanned in raster images when we are using the raster images. So in order to display the rasterized image using video technique, it is necessary to organize the picture into precise patterns, so required by the graphics display processors. This process is called scan conversion. May suppose here we want to display a triangle in the raster image. Suppose here I want to display a triangle in this way. Then which point on this line need to be displayed? That how we, for that we scan each and every line from top to bottom and left to right. That is known as scan conversion. To find out the precise pattern required to be displayed on the screen, it is necessary that the information organized and presented at appropriate frame rates. Frame rates are required: 60 frames per second, 40, 30, whatever. Why it is required? So that the image is a steady image, no flickers occur with that image. So avoid the flickering. The frame buffer rate is there, refresh rate is there, all these things are used, and these are scanned from top to bottom and left to right, that already I told. There are three ways: real time scan conversion, most frequently used in vehicle simulation, run length encoding, generally used to store the images and transmit the images, that is run length encoding. Frame buffer memory, commonly used for image display in workstations and computer graphics or computers with graphics capability, these are used. So among these three ways, two we are going to study in detail: the run length encoding and frame buffer memory. Now see what is mean by run length encoding. Okay, so run length encoding, here larger areas of the picture have the same intensity and the color. Larger area of the picture have the same intensity and color. It specifies the number of successive pixels on the given scan line with the given intensity. Means suppose this entire one on this scan line, all these pixels I want to make it bright, or some picture I want to display it, then how many bits are there and what is its intensity? In black and white, 0 and 1 is used. 0 means picture is not going out, that pixel is not going to be displayed. And 1 means picture of that pixel is going to be displayed. For that, the simple method is used, the intensity and the run length. 0, no display, and 1, to display in black and white. And run length means successive pixels on a given scan line with a given intensity. For example, here it shows the simple monochrome black and white. 0, all are 0. This 30, it is the pixel size from 0 to 30 and 0 to 30. Here it is from 30 and here it is 30, and here you can observe it is 30. So this is the frame of size 30 into 30. So the if we consider this first scan line, all are 0. No picture is displayed here, no pixel we are going to display. So 0 And how many bits it is 0? It is bits, 30 bits it is 0. Then similarly here, if we consider this scan line shown here, first 7 bits are 0. For example, somewhere it is not actually shown here. So first 7 bits are 0, next 8 bits are 1, and remaining 15 bits are again 0. First 7 bits are 0, intensity is 0. This is intensity. Okay, and this 7 indicate the successive number of pixels on the scan line for with that intensity. So first are 0, then again 1 for 8 bit, and remaining 15 bits are 0. If we consider the last one, what happens here? All the 30 pixels of intensity 1. 1 intensity of all successive 30 bits. So it is shown here on the raster image of size 30 into 30. So total pixel by pixel storage is 13 to 30 means 900 intensity levels or values can be stored here. 01, 01, 01 in this way, as it is a black and white image. Okay. So solid figures are easily handled with run length encoding. If there are solid figures, the example we have already seen solid figure. It is easily extended to include the color. Here we can include the color easily. For that, what we need to do? We need to add the color codes, intensity of the particular colors. So for color intensity of each of these red, green, blue color, we require three RGB colors, red, green, and blue intensity. So accordingly, it generates the color and then process. The rand length. Rand length means preceding by the successive number of pixels with that particular color. Means how many number of pixels with 0, 0, 0 intensity. Suppose 8 pixels. 9 pixels are with 0, 0, 0, 1 intensity. So in this way, the rand length, the number of pixels with that given color, and then the color intensity code for RGB, red, green, and blue. So these red, green, and blue guns are used to normally electron guns to generate the image. For a given color display in each individual color, gun is either completely off or fully on. Means either its value is 0 or 1. In between value is not allowed. Means in this case 0, 0, 1, the red and green gun is completely off. Only blue color gun is available or one on. In this 001, red and green color gun is completely off while only blue color gun is on. Suppose I say 111, all the three color guns are active now or on now. If I say 000, all three color guns are off now. And in this way, the encoding for scan line of previous line, whatever, here the example is given. So 15, suppose we consider here yellow triangle on a blue background. Yellow triangle on a blue background. So in the previous one, okay, 7 bits are 0. This 15 scan line, 7 bits are 0, 8 bits are 1, and 0 bits are 15. So 0 means background color and 1 means this is the foreground or the triangle, particular triangle. So 8 bits are for the triangle and the remaining all bits are for background color. Correct? So here, if we consider the same one, 0 to 7 bits are now blue. Why? Because here background is blue. Then next 8 bits are yellow. Why? Because the triangle is of color yellow. And the remaining 15 bits are again blue as considering the background of this. So these are, suppose these 0 to 7, these are blue. These remaining 15 all are blue. And these 8 bits are all yellow. these 8 bits are all yellow. So in this way, how here the pattern is used to show it? So the standard pattern is used here, as there are 3 color guns, 8 possible colors are there. Black, if all are 000, means all guns are off, then black color it emits. 100 for red, 010 red means only red color is active. Green means only green gun is active. Blue means only blue gun is active. Yellow 1100 red plus green combination. Cyan, green plus blue combination. Magenta, red plus blue combination. And white, all should be active for white color. Now in the background we want the blue color, and in the foreground or in for the triangle we want the yellow color. So the 8 bits are in yellow color, middle one, and the 7 bits and the 15 bits are in blue color. So you can observe 15 bits are here in this blue color, 001, then actually it is 7 and this is 8. 7 bits are in again blue color, as it is a background, and 8 bits are in yellow color. For yellow it is 110. So first 7 bits are blue, then middle 8 bits are yellow, and the last 15 bits are blue. In this way the triangle is generated in yellow color with blue background. So all these scan lines, same way, this is for scan line 15. In the way scan line 14, scan line 13, all the scan lines are generated, or the values are created, and this triangle is generated on that screen. So disadvantage of this, that since the run lengths are stored sequentially, adding or deleting lines or text from the picture is difficult and time consuming. As I told that one by one scan line, this first scan line the values are stored all zeros, then second one all zeros, third scan line all zeros, fourth scan line, then in this scan line some values we need to change here, background blue. Here all are blue, background blue, and these 2 pixels are only yellow. In this way, one by one line, run line is generated for each and every scan line. So it is slow process and time consuming. There is overhead involved with both encoding and decoding. So it is encoded here and then it is decoded to generate the picture. Storage requirement can approach twice that for pixel by pixel storage. For short runs, double storage requirement is there. So that is about the run length encoding. Now the next one, frame buffer. Frame buffer part, some part we have covered in the unit number 1. Frame buffer, for which purpose it is used? So frame buffer is a large continuous piece of computer memory which is used for storing pixel values or pixel information. At minimum there is one memory bit for each pixel in the raster. This amount of memory is called bit play. So here one example is shown. This is a frame buffer. So one bit is required for each pixel. If it is a black and white monochrome image, then one bit, one pixel, it stores the value either 0 or 1. 0 means no display the picture, 1 means display the picture. There is 1 bit per pixel. So if it is 1024 into 1024 size raster image frame buffer, then 2 raised to 20 or 10,48,576 memory bits in a single bit plane we can store. If it is a size 1000 into 24 multiply with 1000 into 24, then total 2 raised to 20 memory bits we can store. The picture is built up in the frame buffer 1 bit at a time. that I told the that start from here, correct? Then go for here, go for here, go for here in this way from top to bottom and left to right. If we want to display this particular one, if we want to display this particular one, this suppose we want to display this pixel, then it becomes 1 here. If we want to don't display this pixel, then it is 0. Simply store the value. So the picture is built up in the frame buffer 1 bit at a time. Because memory bits has only two states, 0 or 1, a single bit plane generates a black and white display. 0 means no display, 1 means display that in the black color. So black and white display only there, and 1 bit per pixel the information is stored. A digital to analog conversion is there. A single bit register is required. Why? Because there is a 1 bit per pixel. That's why single bit register is sufficient. So this register, suppose this pixel information is to be displayed on the CRT. Whether to display or not display. So that pixel information is stored in a register. Suppose it is 1, means that pixel we want to display on the CRT screen. Then that 1 is passed to this DAC, digital to analog converter. Then analog converter value is given to the electronics. Horizontal, vertical, we have studied it in CRT, all these things. So that electron gun beep is passes through all these things and then it emits the light on the CRT. If it is 1, then the value will be displayed or their black spot will be displayed on the CRT. If the value is 0, then no spot is displayed. It is a blank screen for that particular pixel. So DAC is used to convert the bit value 0 or 1 to analog signals for refreshing the screen. That is simple frame buffer work in black and white images. Now color, that whatever we have seen in the previous, it is black and white. That's why 0 or 1 value is only stored. 0 and 1 bit register is required, which passes the information to DAC. Convert digital to analog, the electron gun take this input and according to display the pixel on the CRT screen. Now, frame buffers with color or gray levels can be achieved in the display using additional bit panel. So you can observe here there are 3 bit panels, 1, 2 and 3, n number of bit panels are there. Example here 3 bit panels are given. So the result for n bit per pixel color depth n is a collection of n bit planes, 2^n colors are possible. So in this way how many colors are possible? 8 colors are possible. Here it is shown 0000001. Why? Because n is equal to 3, 3 bit plane it is. So as it is a 3 bit plane, only 8 colors are possible, which are ranges from 0 to 7. So here 000 means 0, 00 whatever, 0100 means 6. So how many there are 0 to 7 numbers, I mean 8 total colors are possible. Total 8. Why? Because n is equal to 3. Means total 2^n intensity levels are possible. How many intensity levels are here possible with n is equal to 3? 8 intensity levels are possible. Now, these bit planes, 1, 2 and 3 bit planes are there. It gives the value to this register. For example, 0, 1, 0. So it is red, green and blue suppose. Red. Okay, this is for green and for blue. So here it B, which color it shows? Green color it shows. So that value is given to this 2^n DAC, digital to analog converter, which convert this digital value into analog, give the input to the electron gun, then electron gun passes this through the all the CRT screen and then display it on the C. NCERT raster screen, that pixel. Now which color have available or appear here? The green color will appear here in this example. So here the green color will appear. Why? Because it is 010. If it passes 100, then here red color will be appear. If it passes 001, then blue. If all 1, then white color will be displayed. So in this way, 8 intensity variables are possible or values are possible. This converted into an analog voltage and this DAC converted into analog passes to the electron gun and generate the colors. So a 3-bit plane, suppose we use here 3-bit plane frame buffer for 1024. Okay, total size of this frame buffer is 1024 into 1024. So total how many number of bits are possible here? This 1024, for this 1024 into 1024, and for this 1024 into 1024. So total 3 into 1024 into 1024, which is 31,45,728 bit pixels are there in this 3-bit plane buffer. That is about the color. Now suppose we want to increase this 2^n value, okay? So in that case, lookup table is used to increase the number of available intensity levels. What is this lookup table? Lookup table, it include one or more bits than the value of n. Means W is always greater than this n. W is always greater than this n, whatever the value. So it automatically increase the size, the number of bits are increased. Here W is equal to 4, means each bit of size 4. Lookup table must contains 2^n entries. 8 entries are there. If n is equal to 3, 0000101010100110, in this way. So 8 entries are there in the lookup table. So total 2^W intensities are possible, and these are given to the DAC as an input, which convert this analog digital into analog signal. Electron passes through the electron gun, and accordingly the picture is displayed on the raster, CRT raster. Accordingly, picture is displayed on the CRT raster. That is about the simple frame buffer and the 3-color frame buffer. Example is again shown here, different way the frame buffers are used. Because there are 3 primary colors, a simple frame color, color frame buffer is implemented with 3-bit planes. The example already I told that 3-bit planes are there, this one and this one. One for each primary color. Now 3 registers are used here separately. This one, this way also we can use. A single 3-bit register we can use. 1-bit for each color, or you can use 3 separate registers, 1-bit register. You can use 3-bit 1 register or 3 registers of 1-bit. Any one is possible. DAC that convert it into the analog signal, digital to analog. And accordingly the value passes through these color guns. If it is 0, no blue color will be displayed. If it is 0, no red color will be displayed. And as it is 1, only green color will be displayed here. No combination of all other colors. If all are 111, white color will be displayed. If green and red and green are 11, then orange color will be displayed. If blue and green are there, then cyan color will be displayed. So whatever the bits it passes through this register, accordingly the color will be displayed. So these three primaries, red, green, and blue, are combined at a CRT to generate 8 colors. And these 8 colors are like this. If all are 0, black color will be displayed. Clear? Now we are going to see some examples of this frame buffer, scan conversion, video basics are there, what intensity levels are they used, how many frames per buffer, what is the refresh rate used in video basics, etc. That we are going to see here in short as an example. So scanning pattern and frequency of repetition are based on human visual perception and electronic principle. It is not fixed for all the systems. Every system has different frequency is used, different rate of refresh rate is used. If individual images are presented at a rate greater than the time required for the visual system to resolve individual images, one image persists while the next is presented. Means if the rate at which the image is displayed is greater than our visual system, then in that case what happens? Before presenting the next image, the first will remain as it is while the next is being presented. Is that combination or the rate, the refresh rate between the two images that we present, it match with the human visual system? Otherwise, either we see the flickering image or not possible to see the image properly. Once the image is there, before we see it properly, the second image comes. Before we see it properly, the third image comes. If the refresh rate is very high, it may happen. In this way, the refresh rate, frame buffer rate, update rate, whatever used, it must match with the human visual system. The minimum picture presentation or update rate is 25 frames per second. Minimum refresh or repetition rate is twice. See, the repetition rate is normally twice than the picture presentation rate. So picture is presented 25 frames per second, but its refresh rate is 50 frames per second. Refresh rate is max twice than the presentation rate. In movie film picture presentation rate is 24 frames per second, while update rate is 48 frames per second in movies, films, whatever we have seen. In that case, presentation rate is 24 frames per second. Why the presentation rate is required? So that the image should be visible for us, or proper visible. It should be proper visible, so that once image is there, before coming to the next image, that should be there in our eyesight. So in movie film picture presentation rate is 24 frames per second, while update rate is 48 frames per second. The same effect is achieved in video using technique called interlacing. The American standard video system uses 525 horizontal lines with a frame viewing aspect ratio 700 vertical lines. Means 525 horizontal and 700 vertical lines are there. The repetition frame rate is normally 30 frames per second in American standard video system. 525 horizontal lines with 700 vertical lines. That is shown here in this simple diagram. How these 525 lines are divided, frame lines. Now see, all these 525 lines are not scanned. These are scanned one after another. Means it is divided into two fields. One field contains odd number, while other contains all even number scan lines. One field contains all odd numbers, while other contains all even scan lines. For example, suppose this is a frame. It is shown here, one of the frame. So in this odd 1, 3, 5, 7. So in one field, 1, 3, 5, 7, these scan lines are stored, while in another 2, 4, 6, 8, these are stored. Now scanning is performed top to bottom and left to right, correct? But it not perform one by one. First, all lines are scanned. Okay. Then after scanning completion, it again go to the first one and start the event lines. See, once again, it is not done simultaneously all scan lines. We start from scan number one. So first complete this scan line one, then go for three, then go for five, then seven. And once the seven scan line is completed, go back and start with 2, 4, 6, and 8. Means first odd lines are scanned and then even lines are scanned. So this frame buffer for this entire 525 lines are divided into two fields, odd scan field and even scan field. So odd scan field, in this way it is scanned, and 21 lines are vertical retrace. Go to the first one again. In visible, 241 and half lines are scanned one by one in even field, and 21 lines vertical retrace. Retrace is required there. So in this way, actually the scanning is performing raster scan image, not from 1, 2, 3, 4. First odd lines are scanned and then even lines are scanned. For that, it is divided into two fields, odd field and even scan line field. That is shown here again. Now you can see here blue lines are indicate. Here the blue lines, line number 1, line number 3, line number 5, 7, 9, 11, 12, 13. And the red lines are line number 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15. So first these odd lines are completed in this way, their scanning. Why it is 2, 4, 1 and half? You can observe it start from here. Not the entire line is scanned, blue line. It start from here, means it is half. 525, correct? So in that 241 full odd lines and half line odd line. So in this way it is scanned up to this line, then go back, start from the even line. So even line you can observe here, and here it is half of the even line. You can observe here half of the even line, and that's why it is also 241 and half. So in this way odd and even lines are scanned. The same is given here. How much time is required for the scanning? That is written here. Out of 525, only 483 lines actually visible. Due to vertical retrace, 21 lines are for vertical retrace, means 42 lines are for vertical retrace. So remaining 483 lines are actually visible or actual scanned. Vertical retrace means what? See here, we start from here, correct? Again you can observe, it goes here and again start from here. Again it goes here, again start from here. So for that purpose, actual lines, how many are scanned? 483 lines are actually scanned, which are visible. So how much time it require? According to 30 frames per second, how many lines are there total? 515 scan lines. So 63.5 or 0.5 microseconds are required for entire scan line. 63.5 microseconds per scan line are required. So with video aspect ratio, it requires 82 nanoseconds. If we consider there are 644 scan lines, here it is the calculation according to 525 scan lines. If it is 645 scan lines, then it requires 82 nanoseconds. One example is given here. So that is about the run length encoding and frame buffer. CAN conversion methods, lane length encoding and frame buffer.